programme of the series. And what did he say? He said, you can have a party.
So I thought, the Hippodrome.
And I thought, string fellows.
But he said,
Further north.
So I thought, Manchester, home of the programme. But he said,
Further north. I thought, Glasgow, my favourite city. But he said,
Further north. So I thought, Aberdeen. And he said,
go to the northeast for 200 miles till you get to
the Shetland Islands. Britain's most northerly spot. But on reflection, it looks like a great place to have the Christmas show. And remember, he has promised us that party.
Yeah, sausage rolls.
And this is our party.
And you're all very welcome.
And it's being held at the Keljo House Hotel in Lerwick. So go on in, pull your nose, scratch your ears.
Yeah. Ah. What's that pulling me tips on?
It's so fresh.
Like the local lifeboat lads?
Newspaper people?
The local airline?
Helicopter people?
Radio station?
Somebody's on the riddle.
Should you admit to that?
Coffee percolator, cuddly toy, hot glass decanter.
Did she do well?
No.
Let's do well with that great piece of music.
Do you want us out?
Are you asking?
Yeah.
You work for the Shetland Islands Council, don't you?
Yes, that's right.
And you have a very special job.
Well, I've got a very interesting job, yes.
What is it?
Well, I'm called an industrial strategist.
Okay, fine. Oh, dear. And you've also had a slight problem with television for about 2 years or so now, haven't you?
At least 2 years, yes. An extreme problem with television, yes.
And you've even involved your wife in it as well.
Well, she's trying to keep out of it by keeping her own name.
You better tell them, because I'm not.
Well, my name is Blackadder.
This word, we'll be right back.
This word.
We'll be right back.
Blackadder. I never had much trouble with Tony Baker, but someone thought I was Dr. Who once, but they sacked him, so it was all right. A Christmas tree. Something you don't find much of in the Shetlands. Mind you, it's quite a good idea, isn't it? I mean, you can plant this outside your front door, watch it grow, and then all you'd have to do is put a bit of waterproof ollie on it every year. Next is a travelogue, which is treeless, with a song by the Pretenders, 2,000 Miles. Do you come to these batches often? No? Can I get you something from the buffet? Yes?
He's gone 2,000 miles. It's very far. The snow is falling down. It's colder day by day. I'm
You'll never guess who's buried here.
I know, King Arthur.
Now, let me give you a few clues. Kirk Douglas, dimply chin, horns on his head. Tony Curtis in a tide pool, you know, one arm behind his back, you know. Oh, come on, it's a Jarlsulf, and it's a Viking's house.
Oh.
What's wrong with you?
Well, we've got to do it, haven't we?
Oh, come on, then.
It's too tempting.
We'll be right back after this word.
Jenny, you say the nicest things.
Oh, well, Magnus will protect me, won't you, Magnus? This is Magnus.
Oh, no, I'm Magnus, yes, yes.
And he's used to dressing up, aren't you?
Once a year, yes.
Mm-hmm. So what is it you do? What's the name of the thing you do?
Well, I was going to Yale last year in our festival of Hell Yeah.
Well, what does that mean?
Well, it's a huge festival, fire festival. It's held here in Shetland every year on the last Tuesday in January.
Right.
And it culminates in the burning of the galley.
Do you have to have one of those fuzzy things?
Well, it's better if you can do. Melvin here will be guys who got in year 2000.
Oh, you can have a very long beard by the year 2000.
Well, I hope so.
I've got something to say here, you know, this thing you do sounds just like something I can do, which sounds like an excuse to everyone.
Oh, Tony, I don't think you'll be able to grow a good enough beard for that.
I'm fading out of sight, my wheels are the only sound, running at the speed of light, we can't slow down, out on the open road, racing to beat the night. No matter where I go, I guess I can feel alright. So why don't I understand what used to be used to be a simple thing. I can't hold on, I can't return. Time to let go, start to live and learn.
Talking about disguise, caught this.
Oh dear, there's a man in the red puffing.
Dear me, he's so embarrassing. Now, there's one thing I must say about our crew and production team. They have always been willing at the drop of a hat to come round on this side of the camera and help us out, yeah. And to lose their street cred with us with dignity.
Mind you, that is one of his better ones, isn't it? I mean, you can't see him.
No, but really, Uncle Puffin, thank you for the party. It's been a real hoot.
Right, it's been spot on.
And by the looks of these people around here, they need their beakers filling up. All right. This is Malcolm and Anita. Now, Malcolm, you're like a one-man airline, really. You are Logan Air up here.
Up here, yes.
But you don't just look after passengers, do you?
No, we do occasional ambulance flights, and we check the waters for pollution.
And Anita, do you have to be like those girls on the adverts and smile and say, have a nice day and look after people?
Yeah, things like that. Writing tickets, checking in passengers.
Oh dear. Let's have a look what we've got up to.
Logan Air in the Shetland Isles is a bit like a taxi service.
There are 15 inhabited islands, so we can pick people up and drop people off.
And they don't overcharge! Taxi! People about, but they also do a thing called a sea pollution check.
That's right, an aircraft like this goes out over the deep blue sea to check guys.
A bit like a neighbouring watch, you're quite right as well. Sweater. Now I know why the Pope kisses the ground when he gets off planes. Phew. Are you supposed to drive in a pair of green gloves?
I'm a furious flyer. Anyway, for all of you people out there who curse your electricity bills, on this island here they have something that's very, very unique. Don, you look awfully pale. Was it something I did? I didn't fly you all the way to the Fair Isle just to have a look at the view. Tell him, Tom.
Over here, Don. Over here, please. Here in the gathering gloom is the United Kingdom's first commercial aerogenerator.
It was commissioned in 1982, and it means that when there's a good breeze blowing, which there isn't, it has enough electricity for the whole of the Fair Isle. However, when it doesn't have enough, something else happens. Oh. And first of all, there's the diesel generator, and that comes on until there's enough wind to start the aero generator coming on again. Now, diesel generated electricity is mucho costo compared to aero generated electricity, and that's why in every home on the Fair Isle there's this little orange light. And when it comes on, it means that you're using diesel generated electricity. So, the more electrical gadgets you turn off, the more chance there is to work the aero generator and at a cheaper price. Confused? I am too.
Please don't turn the TV off while our program's on. Oh, we must be back on the diesel generator. Well, before I get into some traditional Shetland costume, we want you to guess the year with the news and the views. Here's Simon, Iron Fist Blinks.
On May the 28th in this year, a British team under the leadership of Chris Bonington made the very first successful ascent of Annapurna by the South Face. On June the 18th, there was a general election which the Conservatives won with a majority of 30, and Edward Heath became your Prime Minister. In April, the ill-fated Apollo 13 mission was launched. It was badly damaged by a tank explosion on the 14th, but after a complex rescue operation, the crew splashed down safely on the 17th of April. In November, Russia's Lunokhod 1 began a walk on the moon's surface.
when no one else can understand me.
The Navy weren't very happy in July because on the 31st of that month there ended a 283-year-old tradition when the last tots of grog were served. Also in July, John Newcombe and Margaret Court became Wimbledon champions. Elvis was in the charts, so was Norman Greenbaum and Dave Edmonds, along with Lee Marvin. And this.
Sugar. Oh, honey, honey. You are my candy girl. And you got me wanting you.
But what was the year? What do you mean you look silly? This is a proper Shetland wool beard, knitted in the Shetlands.
When you think of making Shetland wool jumpers, you think it's all big factories, lots of machinery, when really it's a home-based industry. It's all done in little crofts and cottages scattered around the island, and they're busily knitting away to fill in orders for our Christmas stockings. But next it's across the island to Scalloway. I like this. Do you think I look like a fishwife, Don? Do you like it? I'm not fishing for compliments or anything, but...
Ain't got no regrets. I ain't losing track of which way I'm going. I ain't gonna double back, no. Don't wanna misplay. Put on no display. An angel, no, but I know my way. Oh yeah. Oh. Oh, midnight blue. Oh. Midnight blue. Oh. You were the restless one. Looking for a double dare. I won't apologize for the things I've done and said, but when I win your heart, I'm gonna paint it cherry red. I don't wanna talk about it. What you did to me, I can't live without it. You might think that it's much too soon for us to go this far. The one who can feel the sun right in the pouring rain. I won't say when, don't know when, but soon there's gonna come a day, baby, I'll be back again. Yeah, I'll be back for you.
What am I saying? They do really well here.
They do lots of things really well in the Shetland, Tony.
No, fresh fish, any sort you want, this is the place to be. I mean, they catch it, they process it. It's really great, you know, and it's alive and well. The fishing industry is alive and well and kicking in this Shetland Isles at the moment. It's brilliant.
Tony, you do know you have to cook it first. Who knows?
John Ferguson from Radio Shetland. Now, come on, John, tell us, what sort of audience do you get? Because that is terrible.
Well, we do 2 hours a day, and we reckon that we get 80% of the population in any week.
That is really good. Now, you've got a special challenge for Jenny, haven't you?
Well, yeah, we'd like her to go out and interview a fella at the museum called Andrew Williamson, who's an interesting man, but he speaks in Shetland, and we want her to come back with something that she can broadcast.
He speaks in Shetland?
Yeah, he uses the Shetland accent.
That is going to be really difficult.
Yes, hello.
All right, the suave one here is John, editor
photo of the Shetland Times. What's your circulation like?
Well, it's not very good in this weather. It's a bit cold.
You may get cold.
They do.
He's obviously the Shetland comedian as well.
No,
now, you've set up a little challenge for Tony Roney, haven't you?
Well, yes, we've been thinking for some time of getting... What are you doing? We've been thinking of getting a new fish prices reporter.
Mm.
And the fish prices are...
When Alt Mansey's crew below the sound said, him and see the den around. No, if her limmer o' a lass, ne'er heeding through the town would pass. Set piatlin' weird lazy days into the ace of 4 days. Should stamp with second angry fit. What? No, daddy, wasn't it? Him do that careful with the group of cross all flattened with the fluke. Dice, weary, crack, he slipped the sits. He's hassled him, he busy lips.
Islands are a bit like one big community. Everybody knows everybody else, and news travels like wildfire. Well, now it can travel on SIBC, which is the Shetland Islands Broadcasting Company. It's a local radio firm run by a local bloke, Ian Anderson.
They will be closed on Christmas Day and New Year's Day only. That's only on Christmas Day and New Year's Day.
It's run like an American station. I mean, everybody jumps up and down, and there's no sitting down. The adverts are spoken and there's non-stop music, which is the way we like it. It's on cable, so it serves Lerwick and the local area. Which brings me nicely onto the travelogue. With a power play from both SIBC and No Limits, it's the Pet Shop Boys, and You Were Always On My Mind. And good luck to Ian and the team. Keep it tuned right here.
Somebody's been a part of Lowick for a very long time, since 1600, wasn't it?
Well, the family has, not me personally.
This is Jim, who's run the Keldrow House Hotel for how long?
19 years now.
When was your first film crew up here?
19 years ago.
Ooh.
And who was a member of that motley crew?
Your producer, he should remember, he carried the suitcases.
19 years, that's a long time.
So what's next on the menu then?
The chart reports.
Give us a mic and I'll do it. Excuse me. 19 years, I was about, naught. And now it's time for the chart report with news of Christmas 40 from Gallup. While I search for a rhyme with Gallup, the Christmas chart has 21 on the way down, 13 festive climbers in the chart, 2 stopped in their frozen treks, and 4 new entries. And do we really need the snow? Thank you. So now it's time for you to see the full chart used by the BBC and the record companies all over the world as the Christmas 40 gets unfold. And at 40, it's hot and a new entry, There's the Girl. 2 down and Climby Fish are new in with Rise to the Occasion. Down, 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 then up 7 go Kiss, Reason to Live. It's the man in a red puffin. The satellite is in a lower orbit, then new in for Cher.
Mm.
Is that head stuck? It just needs a bit of a twist round. Give it a pull.
Ooh.
Yank it a bit. Ow! Oh, look. I found someone.
Dry your eyes. I never could bear to see you cry. Someday your love will shine through. Show you the feelings if you never really knew. Baby, don't you lose that thunder talking about the fire in your eyes. You're looking at me, but you still don't believe that maybe, 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 maybe I found someone to take away the
and Cher alike.
What about Ballup?
Gallup? Ballup? No such word. Up 4 for the Smiths.
Last night I dreamt that somebody loved me.
Oh, well, I suppose it's Christmas. Up 4 for Nina Simone again.
My baby just cares for me.
Must be the spirit of goodwill. New in for Crush, House Arrest. Up 10 for Sunita GTO and...
Down. What about...
Get off.
Oh, go on, be a Christian gov. What about Salad then? That's short for Shropshire.
Or the other one. An ideal world.
I wish you'd put your head back on you. It was much better.
Before you point the finger, I'd hope the whole thing disappeared. Remember, empty words will fall and fall upon the deafest ear. You won't give in without a fight, and foul play without a doubt. No silver lining to be seen. It's thundercloud. Oh, that's not allowed in the ideal world. We'd be free to choose, but in my real world, oh, you can bet we're gonna lose.
The Christians up 14 this week and the highest climber. There's a lot of those Powerplay flashes in the Christmas chart.
And more to come, Wally.
I beg your pardon?
Jump Junior, tighten up.
I just can't stop drinking.
No comment, up 12, then down. But now, greetings from the bands. We've had festive Christmas calls coming into the No Limits office all week, and here are just a few.
Hello to all you No Limits viewers. We'd like to thank you for supporting Erasure throughout the year, and we hope that we'll come up with the goodies next year.
Hello, this is Brian Adams. I want to wish all the listeners of No Limits a very, very happy Christmas.
Hi, this is Robbie Neville, wishing everybody happy holidays and Merry Christmas this year.
Hi, this is Alexander O'Neill, wishing all the viewers of No Limit a Merry, Merry Christmas and a very happy holiday.
Hi, this is John from the Hooters, wishing a happy Christmas to all our fans and everyone at No Limits.
Thanks for making 87 a great year for us, and all the best in 88.
Hi, this is Debbie Gibson wishing you happy holidays and a happy new year.
Hi, this is Joe Elliott on behalf of Def Leppard, wishing all you No Limits watchers a very Merry Christmas and a rocking new year.
And have a great Christmas holiday from all at No Limits.
And a terrific new year.
New order.
No, new year.
New order up five, touched.
Nothing you are.
By the hand of God. Up 11 goes Jelly Bean, Jingo, the others.
Down.
Stand still for Turn Back the Clock. Down and up eight for the wetties, Angel Eyes. Down this time for Jelly Bean and up for Simply Red. And the 10.
With six out of the Christmas 10 being No Limits power plays. But Shaky Down to Power Down.
Up 11 to 8, you saw it earlier, Belinda Carlisle, Heaven is a Place on Earth.
And at 7, up 13, The Real Thing from Q Tony Nat King Cole.
When I fall in love, it will be forever.
Down for Michael and
The 5.
Down 1 for Alison's Love Letters.
Love letters straight from your keep us so near, while apart. I'm not alone in the night. When I can have all the love.
Alison at 5. Down also for the other version from Rick Astley.
When I fall in love.
Quite enough, thank you. Put your head back on.
Up 3 for a charity record, Mel and Kim.
Mel and Kim at 3. Up 6 to number 2 go the Pogues and Kirsty
Widsteads. The Pogues and Kirsty McColl at number 2. But the Christmas number 1 and very popular too.
It's the Shoppies and Always on My
Mind. And that's the chart from No Limits for Christmas 1987. But once again, it's the record you all want to see.
So once again, here is some. While we look at the album chart movers and the down unders.
It's Morris Minor and the Majors with
UK, from a baby to a boy to a man today, and I'm a musical man, and I'm a man of verse, but I got a little problem and it's getting worse. My life was so well planned, surviving in a jardin in a funk band, cause rapping is my bread and butter, but it's hard to rap when you're born with a stutter.
Well, no one's ever seen what I mean. From the age of 13, we've all been caught in a mousetrap. So join with us in the stutter rap.
Well, it was 82 when I joined the boys.
And I was hip.
And I was cool.
But now I lost my poise. The kids are fans are starting to doubt. When you open your mouth and nothing comes out. And it breaks my heart the way I'm not on the chart.
Cause the record's nearly over when the vocals start.
And I'm down and out,
and I'm down on my luck.
And I'm living on my own and I'm dying for a friend to say,
you're great!
But I'm under the hammer, cause all I seem to do is
come on, man.
Summer! Well, no one's ever seen what I mean. From the age of 13, we've all been caught in a mousetrap. So join with us in the rap.
Well, interviewers, turn away. Who wants to be covered with spray?
Talking to me
for more than an hour
is equivalent to an April shower.
It's tough, tough, tougher than tough. It's worse than Benny Hill,
and that's bad enough.
Something must be wrong with your
vocal
technique
when the 12-inch mic goes on for a week.
I was rapping in my club the other night
when nothing I said was coming out right.
The crowd got angry,
and this one man,
he was gonna throw a bottle,
he was gonna chuck a can, chuck a can.
Well, there's no use pretending that this lot didn't give us a run for our money earlier on, boy, did they give us some time. Where are you from?
This is the Larry Lightboat crew you're with.
It's not Santa Claus. And when did it start here, the lifeboat?
1930.
He's done his research, this lad. So did you enjoy it this morning? Didn't we have fun? This is Lerwick Lifeboat, Soldian. And as it happens in so many places we go to, of course they're having their air sea rescue drill.
In conjunction with Bristow's helicopters.
Now what happens is a person is dumped over the side, then a helicopter comes along, and it winches somebody up and puts them onto dry land again.
So we needed to win an able volunteer.
You?
No, but I've been chucked off a boat.
I've been winched off one.
Budgie, we chucked him off as well, didn't we?
And we've been put on the front of one. Oh. No, seriously. This isn't really a drill, this is for real. Because our faithful researcher, Louise Ludlam, is now needed for the facts programme.
She's been brilliant all year, absolutely brilliant. Alan Walsh, the producer, rang us up this morning and said, could he have her back as soon as possible, please? So, ever willing to please.
They hung a sign outside at the 7, down at the highway, such a busy bee. So sign it, honey, sign up for heaven, but till tonight it's you and me.
A couple of lads from the Bristow Helicopter Company.
They're actually Bristow Coast Guard Search and Rescue Unit.
I know this is going to be a silly question then, but what are your general duties then?
To respond to any call within about 150 miles of Shetland that the Coast Guard give us. And the majority of those calls are for fishermen who are in trouble. Either they've been caught by a winch or they've had a serious injury. And we go out, we're on call 24 hours a day.
I hope you're not on call at the moment.
Not on call at the moment, no. We've got another crew on call.
Can I ask you one more question?
Dreaming of a wife.
Have you ever serviced a lighthouse? Sunborough International Airport on the southern tip of the mainland. Now here's a question for you, right? What has Man Friday and a flasher got in common?
I don't know, but you're going to tell me.
I am. All right, are you sitting comfortably? Then I shall begin.
Begin
or begin? Are you listening?
Are you sure you're listening?
So there you go then. That was interesting, wasn't it?
Huh? Oh, yeah. Would you just like to recap again, please?
Right, well, Robert Louis Stevenson's grandfather designed this lighthouse and the one at Unst as well, you see. So, there you got the flasher. And Robert Louis Stevenson wrote Robinson Crusoe. Man Friday, get it? Flasher, Robinson Crusoe, Man Friday. No? Been planting me tree, anyway.
Oh, look, on reflection, how do you think this series has gone?
On reflection, I think it's been great. I mean, the music's been terrific.
The production team have been as faithful as ever, and the crew.
Our regional presenters have done a great job.
But there's a special thanks for you.
Yeah, thanks for watching in the first place. It was great. Thanks for all them brilliant letters you've written in.
And thanks for coming up to us in the streets again. Hey, are you No Limits? How's Hamish? He's all right?
Yeah, thanks very much.
Right. This isn't goodbye, though. It's just au revoir, because just before he got carried off by the lifeboatman, the man in the red pelican.
that was a red puffin.
But anyway, he did mention presenters for the next series. Guess who?
Hello,
it's me. So don't forget, in July, the next series of the world's fastest and best watched TV rock show.
The Roxy.
Don't mention the Roxy.
I mean, No Limits. So.
Sometimes I wonder, are you coming back as well?
Are you?
Oh, no.
Let's swamp off.
Goodbye.
Bye.
I miss you.
Come on.
I miss you.
They're getting bored with you.
I've been waiting for so long, and now I finally found someone to stand by me.
And I hope